Grandee with his most favourite wife, Ridgy. They had been together for 5 years by then. And this was the last time I saw Ridgy with his man, Grandee, the latter still accepted as a member of our gang. Grandee had been deposed from his role as an alpha for about half a year by then. Increasingly marginalized with no more perks. Grandee's situation as an ex-alpha was becoming increasingly untenable in our gang. And before the end of the first week of September, 2021, he was finally ousted. Ridgy was left to fend for her medium-sized family of possibly 7 to 8 members. The younger four were all fathered by Grandee. Her only support was her two older daughters, Ruby and Rudy. At first, I thought their life would continue more or less the same as other non-royalty in our gang. No more perks. But at least they could just get on with their life. A life that they would not live under fear with the same rank whence they came from. And it became increasingly clear to me that Ridgy was from the bottom of the totem pole, like Gypsy. With Grandee gone, the ball was over. But I was wrong. They really had fallen harder than I thought. Ridgy's family was becoming increasingly marginalized. She and her kids with Grandee were shunned by others. but the worst was yet to come for them. Persecution. Before the end of October, Ridgy was beginning to sport bruises and wounds. She and her younger kids were becoming more skittish. But the worst was to see the same persecution being dished out to her kids with Grandee as well. This female is one of Ridgy's unnamed daughters. No one was coming to defend Gigi, not even Ridgy herself. It seemed both Ridgy and her kids with Grandee had resigned themselves meekly to the discrimination and persecution. Her kids had to look after themselves from then on. had taken the worst hit in this sudden reversal of fortune. Her mother, Ridgy, was no longer her former loving self. Poor Gigi was only 5 months old then, and she had a long future before her. Fortunately, Vivi, Fifi, and Diddy would stick together with her. But by December, the persecution seemed to have stopped, and life seemed tolerable for Ridgy once again. Still being sidelined, but at least there was peace for them. Being left to themselves was the greatest blessing by then. By the end of December, 2021, it seemed Ridgy was beginning to look healthier once again. And Gigi could mingle with some of her peers once again. But still, that wasn't the Ridgy we used to know. Some part in her had become distant and cold, while another part of her was still in a trance. Fortunately, Gigi could still count on her older sisters. It seemed a part of her was gone totally. Perhaps lost forever. Perhaps time could heal. But things for her had taken another turn for the worse. She had been picked on and harassed again. The persecution had been ongoing for at least a few days by the time I saw her. Her persecutors weren't happy with just that, though. They carried on until the humiliation was total and complete. And by the end of April, Ridgy had lost half of her left ear and most of her right ear completely. She had been stigmatized for life. Their ears are important for facial language too. Despite what had happened, she still received the occasional nips and bites well into the summer. I have no idea who her persecutors were, or who had been holding a grudge against her in our gang. But she had already lost the last sparkle in her eyes. Nothing could be rekindled again in her. She became increasingly withdrawn and reclusive. And it had become increasingly difficult to spot her. By July, she seemed to have perked up a bit with the birth of her first grandchild, Grady. If she still seemed distant, at least she was making an appearance more often. Throughout the summer months of 2022, I could spot her once every few visits. For a time I thought she was on the mend, surrounded by her son and daughters. And the newest member in her family, Grady. Thank you. But she must have become increasingly reclusive again. It would be another 3 months before I could spot her again. There, and only very briefly. And almost another week later, I saw her again. By that time, she appeared to be all alone by herself. And that is my last footage of her. And that image of her hunching forward, almost in complete despair, will haunt me forever. I had been holding on to a false hope that she would still pop up eventually, given there was almost a 3 months break before she appeared once again last time. But after almost a year, I had to, however reluctantly I am, admit that Ridgy had left us forever. Yes, she had gone. She had left her grandson, Grady, a son, Diddy, and daughters, Vivi, Fifi, Gigi, Rudy, Ruby, and possibly two more unnamed ones behind. As early as the end of February last year. I have no idea how old Ridgy was when I first met her in 2016. But given she already had 3 to 4 older daughters then, I would say she was between 16 to 17 years of age when she left us. But my viewers, I don't want you to leave with an image of her in despair only. I want you to remember her in her former confident and loving self. Grandee did sneak back to see Ridgy and his kids in the first week of October 2021 for one last time before he had gone forever. Rest in peace, Ridgy. I don't know exactly when she passed away last year, but I reckon she didn't live long enough to see her other grandson, Graffy.